I'm Monica Pearson with This Week in Black History. It was 53 years ago today that President Lyndon B. Johnson signed the Voting Rights Act, guaranteeing African Americans the right to vote. This was a right already supposedly granted by the 15th Amendment to the U.S. Constitution in 1870. However, as the years passed, enforcement of the amendment grew weak. Across the country, but especially in the South, black voters were turned away on the basis of literacy, property ownership, and the ability to pay poll taxes. By the 1950s, the rise of the civil rights movement made the issue of voting rights difficult to ignore. Civil rights leaders such as Medgar Evers organized voter registration projects in the face of violent opposition from white supremacists. The right to vote was one of the core issues at the March on Washington, the site of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s I Have a Dream speech. Congress passed civil rights acts in 1957, 1960, and 1964 to expand the government's ability to protect voting rights and dismantle segregation. But President Johnson's Voting Rights Act went a step further, outlawing literacy tests, moral character tests, and poll taxes. It sought to protect not just African Americans, but all minorities, as well as Americans with disabilities.